Thank you for having me. My name is Gabriel. I work as the Marketing and Research Director with Bauer Media Norway. And we are one of two commercial national networks in Norway. It's P4 Group and it's Bauer, and we're the second largest. I'm coming back to some figures on that later. So let's see, this is the this is what I'm going to talk about. It's the FM shutdown that probably most of you have heard about. We were the first country in the world to shut off FM. I'm going to talk to you about that. Oh yeah, of course, you're going to translate. And then I'm also going to talk about the new measurement we have in Norway. We went to Nielsen in 2019, so I'm going to go through the history of what we did, going from Kati via Kantar to Nielsen, and where we are today.
And we will talk about the measurement, about the history, about where we are today, from Nielsen, which was until 2019, and then what happened, and from the transition from Kati measurement to other methods.
And finally, I'm going to go through the consequences, what happened with the market. Did it go up, did it go down, and what happened to the press? Did the audience love it or hate it? All those kinds of things. First, just a few facts about Norway. I don't know if you know this. You see the country up there, the red one. It's quite long, it's going from there to far up north. We are a population of about 3 million. I know you told me in the car yesterday, well, no, 2 days ago, that it's 7 or 8 in Serbia, so we're a smaller country than Serbia. And in the Oslo Fjord area, it lives in the Oslo Fjord area, is right there. It's a small area. And there's the densely populated, there's more or less the city area of 1.5 million and 22%.
Evo nekoliko činjenica o Norveškoj, ukupna populacija je 5,3 miliona, što je koliko znam nešto manje nego u Srbiji, s tim što je najveća gustina naseljenosti u ovom delu Oslo Fjordova, gdje je 1,9 miliona stanovnika, što je 22% populacije.
And we are quite a big country in terms of size. We are the 67th biggest country in the world, but only the 107th biggest country by population, so it's quite scarcely populated. And we are the 47th richest country in GDP. And if you take it down by capita, it's the 8th richest country in the world, and that's due to oil. We found oil in the early 70s out here, and that made us rich. So we're Europe's Kuwait or Saudi Arabia or something.
Osim tog prilično, naravno prilično velike zemlje, 67. zemlje po veličini, 117. po populaciji, na 47. mestu po bruto domaćem prihodu, a na 8. mestu po bruto domaćem prihodu po glavi stanovnika. Ono što je nas učinilo tako bogatim je pronalazak nafte, tako da smo tu negdje kao evropski Kuvajt ili Saudijska Arabija.
And we have, I don't know if you know this, it's not a flat country, it's a lot of mountains and there's a lot of fjords, so we have a difficulty of having close to 100% reach on the radio, so we have close to 3,500 radio transmitters in Norway in order to reach 26% of the population. So it is quite an expensive country to have national broadcasting.
I s obzirom na geografiju nije radna zemlja, ima mnogo planina, fjordova i svega, tako da je bilo neophodno zaposliti 3.500 predajnika da bi pokrili 96% populacije sa FM-om, tako da je to prilično skupa investicija imati radio za nacionalnu frekvenciju u Norveškoj.
And the final point there, I just added that this morning because I had breakfast with Filippo and Goranka this morning and he met the Pope. And I said, I met Oxen and Swindon and I met Jens Stoltenberg, so I just put them up there. Those are some of the famous Norwegian people. Oxen and Swindon, my hero, big skier. Solskjær, the coach of United, Roald Amundsen, discovered, well, the first person to go to the South Pole. Jens Stoltenberg prime minister and head of NATO, etc., etc., etc.
I na kraju sam jutro zvala još neke slavne vežbe, za doručku pričao sa korakom i Dilipom, ili spominjao da je upoznao papu, pa sam onda ja odlučio da dodam ovde još neke poznate Norvežane. Tu su prvi čovjek na zemlju polu, trener United, skijaš, premijer.
Ok, that was a little bit about us. And before I go to Shatan, I'll just show you a bit about the media consumption in a way. This is quite an interesting slide. It's going all the way back from 1961 in terms of percentage of reach. And you can see there from 61 to, what is it, 95, it was dominated by print, TV and radio. And print was the key, close to 80%, 90% daily reach. And radio going a bit up and down, and TV is gradually growing. And then for the next few years, internet came in 94, 95. You can see the growing rate of internet, and you can also see here where TV surpassed print. And I was working in TV at that time, so it was a big day when TV became the biggest reach media in Norway. Shall I just continue with the whole slide before you translate?
No.
Wait.
Is it over? It's like the
And then moving on with the next 10 years, something happened as well. Internet became the biggest reach media in 2011, so it went past TV. And you can see TV going down, print is going down the drain. Radio became bigger than print, also in the same period. And of course, mobile content, including then, of course, internet, but use of mobile is exploding like crazy. And that has also been the situation of the last 5-6 years, where mobile and internet is the biggest, and print is really down the lane, and TV and radio is struggling.
I evo kako se posle razvijala situacija, znači print pada, internet naravno jako raste, kao i mobilne telefonične aplikacije, a televizija isto opada, radio je tu prilično uravnotežen.
But the key takeaway from this slide, which we always talk to the clients in the market about, is how stable radio has been, more or less, until here. And this is where we switched off the FM and something happened. But other than that, it has really been stable, whereas print and TV is really going down. Radio survives almost anything, because it's where even FM shut down. Okay, that was a little bit about background. Now we're going into, okay, this is just the summary of where we are in percent. Now we're going into the actual FM shutdown. And this is basically what happened. This is a map of Norway, and you can see it's divided into six different regions, which were the regions we shut off gradually during the year.
I evo sam šta se desilo kada smo došli do gašenja FM-a, kao što vidite na mapi, Norveška je podeljena na šest delova i FM je postepeno gašen po tim regionima.
And then the background here is that FM network during the, it was built back in the 40s, 50s or something, so we only had room for 5 national stations, that's it. So the government had to decide whether or not to refurbish the FM network or to build the DAB network. So it was decided back in 1995, based on input from us, the broadcasters, that we were to build DAB rather than extending FM.
Ситуација е била таква да је Норвешка било место за само пет националних радиостаница и 90-ти година млада је морала да одлучи шта ће да уради, да ли да обнови мрежу FM-а или да се уведе DAB систем, тако је 95-те године и на нашу сугестију одлучено да се преће на DAB.
And the final decision, because it was a lot of back and forth between 1995 and 2016, but the final decision was made in 2016 that we were to switch off FM in 2017, and that was because the digital listening was about 50% of the digital listening. That was sort of like the kickoff.
И конечно је одлучено че после много премишљења и анализа 2016. Године је дошла конечна одлука да се 2017. исключи FM, а што се десило онако иницијална капсула, то је било када је дигитално слушање прешло 50% на слушање.
And as I said, the map we're showing is a gradual shutdown throughout 2017. We started in Region 1, which is the northern part of Norway, scarcely populated area. We switched that off at the same time in January. And then the mid area, which Trondheim is, the biggest city here. And then the middle of Norway. And then Region 4, quite a big area with Bergen and Stavanger. And Region 5, the Oslo area, the key area, was shut down in September. And then going back north again and doing the Finnmark at the really end of the year in December.
And then in 2017, it started a gradual gašenje po regionu, znači krenulo od prvog regiona, severozadnji koji je i nije gusto naseljen, pa se onda postepeno gasilo jedan po jedan.
And another key thing here is that NRK, the public broadcaster with no commercials, they agreed on after a bit of a pressure from us commercial that they were to go before us by 2 or 3 months. They shut down each region and then we followed 2 to 3 months later on. And the reason for that is that NRK do not rely on commercials, of course, and they have 67% of the listening, so when they shut down, people tend to convert and go and buy their equipment. So the risk for the commercials was limited when they agreed to do this.
I posle malo dogovaranja sa naše strane, ja cenika koji nema reklame, ne oslanja se na reklame, je prihvatio da oni počnu sa gašenjem 2-3 meseca pre komercijalnih radiostanica, upravo zato što se oni za svoj opstanak ne oslanjaju na reklame, a imaju veliku slušnost, neki 67%, tako da kada oni pređu na digital, to će pokrenuti ljude da nabave odgovarajuću opremu kako bi mogli da ih slušaju, pa se samim tim smanjuje i rizik za komercijalne radiostanice kada pređu na digital.
And another key thing here is that local radio stations were allowed to stay on FM, and they are allowed to stay on FM until 2023, but not in the 4 big cities. This is Oslo, Bergen, Trondheim, and Stavanger. That's because if they have a presence there, and we do not have any presence there, that would be that they will steal national revenue from us. So they are allowed to be local stations in the rural parts of Norway, not the urban parts of Norway.
I dozvoljeno je lokalnim radiostanicama da ostanu na FM-u do 2023. Ali to se odnosi samo na lokalne stanice u ruralnim krajevima zemlje, znači ne na 4 najveća grada, Oslo, Bergen, Trondheim i Stavanger, zato što bi oni u suštini krali našu klijentelu ako bi i u ovim gradovima ostali na FM-u, tako da lokalne stanice u manjim mestima su na FM-u do 2023.
Okay, and going back to one of the reasons, because we only had room for 5 stations, and these stations were the 5 we had room for, Radio Norway, which is my station, P4, the other commercial actor, has sort of 2 commercial players, Radio Norway P4, and then MRK, public, had 3 stations. So these were the only national stations for years.
Ovo su, s obzirom da ima mesta samo za 5 nacionalnih radiostanica, ovo su tih 5 stanica koje
And then we went to 36 stations, and as you can see here at the far bottom, this is how it's split. We have room for 36 stations nationally on VOD. And NRK has 50%, they pay 50%, and they have 50%, so they have room for 18 stations. And these are the ones they have. They have not used all 18 stations yet, but they have close to it. And we, the commercial players, we split the 25 each. So we have 8 or 9 stations, and the same with NTG. And underneath here, you can also see the share of listening split between us. And as I mentioned, NRK has 67% of the listening. P4, 22, and we have 11%.
S tim što, kao što vidite, NRK ima mesta za, zauzima 50%, odnosno im, od njima 18 radio stanica, nemaju ih još uvek svih 18, ali su vrlo blizu toga i što se tiče, i oni primaju 50% troškova, što se tiče slušanosti, ne, 67% je njihova slušanost, radio Narge, to je moj radio, gde sam je, ali mi je 25, znači 8 radio stanica, slušam 15% i preostali 25% na 8 stanica je ovih 4 sa svojim radio stanicama i oni imaju nekih 22% što se slušaju se tiče.
And this is, I drew this myself, so sorry about this, I'll try to explain it. This is how the 2017 actually went up here. This is where we all had full FM distribution. It should be an x-axis up here, it disappeared, I don't know where, but it should be 100 here. And the first region was shut down 11th of January, and we did that at the same time. So we lost nationally a couple of percentage points, because it's not very many people living there. And then in week 5, NRK shut down region 2, and we followed 72 days later, then we shut off region 2. And a week later, they shut off region 3, and they we were alone 51 days there, and we shut up region 3, a week later, region 4, in the middle of the year. And then you can see there's a bigger kind of drop in the distribution because there's more people. We were alone here for 86 days, and region 4 we shut down in September. And this one, Oslo area, and I can shut down that in, on the 20th of September. And you can see where how much that is, and we were alone for 79 days. Until we closed that region close to Christmas, and the final region 6 at the end of the year. So, brought us to see on this region.
Raspored kako izgledalo gašenje FM-a, znači u prvom regionu, regionu 1, smo 11. januara svi isključili FM, i tu nije bilo nekog velikog pada slušanosti, jer kao što smo rekli, to nije velika gustina naseljenosti, onda je neka drugi region isključio 8. februara, mi smo ih vratili 72 dana posle toga, pa su onda isključili region 26. aprila, a mi 51 dan kasnije, zato su vidite i koliki je pad što se slušanosti tiče u tome intervalu, pa onda region 4. 21. juna, NRK, mi smo ga isključili 15. septembra, posle 86 dana i peti region je isključen, NRK ga isključio 20. septembra, mi smo to radili negde u oči kraja godine i posle region smo isključili svi u isto vreme, tu negde u oči Božića. Tako da tu negde kraja 2017. više nije bilo distribucije FM signala.
So, what happened? This is the first slide of actual figures after what happened. We can look at each, of course, as you know, in many different periods. We can look at monthly, weekly, and daily, and we can begin with the monthly reach. And you can see there, it's very stable from 2012 and to 2016, where we had 99% here. And then the first year, during the shutdown year, we lost only 1 percentage point, and then we lost another 2 percentage points in the first full year after the distribution.
E sad možda vidimo šta se dešavalo sa Richom u tom periodu, možda pođe mesečni, nedeljni ili dnevni, e sad što se mesečno tiče, kao što je prilično stabilno bilo sve do 2017. bio nekih 99%, u prvoj godini kad smo isključili FM, opao je samo za 1%, 98%, a 2018. na 96%.
And so what happened to the weekly reach? Of course, the weekly reach is lower, and you can see also the dip is lower in the shutdown years. So we lost 3-4 percentage points there, and then another 5, so in total 9 percentage points on the weekly reach. And if you go to the data and do that same thing, and that has an even higher drop in ratings. So a total 3% on monthly, 10% on weekly, and 15% on daily.
Pad, kao što vidite, sa 91% na 87%, pa na 82%, a dnevni rič ima još veći pad, sa tih 67% na 57%, tako da sve u svemu, mesečni rič je opao sa 3%, nedeljni za 10%, a dnevni za 15%.
And the reason for this is, of course, you have fewer radios out there, so people are not exposed to radios on the daily level. They are exposed to radio more on the weekly and monthly level, but on the daily level, less people are exposed to radio, so it makes perfect sense.
To je zato što su ljudi na dnevnom nivou manji izloženi radio nego na nedeljnom mesečno, tako da apsolutno ima smisla.
Okay, going into reach by quarter and also by commercial radio and RK, you see some interesting figures here. Of course, we can start with we always have a dip in Q3 because that's the summer period. But something happened here with commercial radio and NRK. When NRK shut down Oslo and we were in Oslo, you can see we actually grew. So we were close to being the same size as NRK, but that's never happened before. And we, from the commercial side, we hoped not just to borrow the listeners, but to keep them. But sadly, that didn't happen, so we went down like hell in the first quarter after we also shut down the region.
And so, ovo je dnevni reč po kvartalima. U trećem kvartalu je uvijek postoji određeni pad, da je to letna sezona. Međutim, u ovom zaokruženom delu se desilo nešto vrlo zanimljivo. Mi smo se, kao komercijalna radio stanica, prvi put jako približili NRK po broju slučaja, po reču. I ponadali smo se, to je u trenutku kada su oni isključili FM, ponadali smo se da ne samo da ćemo pozajmiti u tom periodu njihove slušalce, nego da ćemo ih i ukrasti, međutim, nažalost, to se nije dogodilo kao što se vidi iz pada koji sledi.
And another key thing here is what happened here. This is we went below 50% in daily reach, and that has never happened before. Of course, during the summer, so it was not a very positive thing in the media. But a positive thing here is the growth we had in total radio in Q4 2018, so it was really growing in the background, so the project was still alive 1 year after.
E sad, ono što je značajna stavka koja se dogodila, koja nam se nikada pre toga nije dogodila i koja nismo uopšte bili srećni, je u trećem kvartalu 2018. godine deo reči prvi put pao ispod 50%, što je bilo jako loše, međutim, već u četvrtom kvartalu 2018. je značajno porastao, tako da se situacija popravila i projekat je još uvek živ.
Okay, and another key thing here is what happened to the listening behavior when we did the shutdown. First of all, this also makes perfect sense. The people, the light users of radio, they were the ones that fell off. They didn't bother to convert to DAB, and the heavy users remain, and they listened the longer. So the average listening time of HTSL went from 123-ish up to 135-ish.
E sad, što se tiče ponašanja slušalaca, baš da se oslušaju duže, ono što se desilo da su oni koji su onako usput i neobavezno slušali radio, oni su prestali da slušaju jer nisu htjeli se baviti time da nabavljaju opet potrebno opremu, međutim oni koji ozbiljnije i posvećenije slušaju radio su naravno to uradili i počeli su da slušaju duže nego što su to pre radili, što se vidi.
But the key thing here is they listen to more stations, and that's basically proof of the pudding that going from 5 to 36 stations was a good idea because the audience really embraced the new stations we came to market with. And you can see here The Big Five, their original FM stations had 98% of the listening in 2010 and onwards, and then we started gradually, and we ended up in 2018 with 35% of all the listening on the new stations that wouldn't exist nationally without AV.
И оно што е ключна ствар е да се почне да слушају више станица, плаве трипографи кои представи оних великих пет станица кои се постојале и ради, и да се оние неки 98% слушаности, а да то полако опада и да се све више и више слушају ове нове станице. Значи, било е добра ствар што се прешло со тих пет на 36, јер су људи почели да слушају нови станице кои да нису прешли на дат, не би ни постојало.
And just to go to the details regarding the fragmented listening that we saw, this is what happened to the Big Five in terms of a number of listeners. And you can see here we went from 2.7 million down to 1.9 in 2018, so it's a loss of 800,000 listeners to the original Big Five. And this is what happened to the new stations, and you can see close to nothing here, and it gradually grew to 1.4 million in 2019.
И ако што се дешло со слушањето по фрагментима, значи ово горе е велики пет станица кои су 2016, значи почело да опада слушаност со неки 2.700.000 слушалаца, стигли су на 1.915.000 2018, а другата остала радио станица кои практично никога не е било ранее су значајно скочиле на неки
And another key thing here is that this is the younger stations. I didn't translate that, but these are the younger stations. There's a number of young stations. We have three of them out of our five going to the young audience. And RKS is the same, and also V4. We take the growth of young people coming into radio very seriously, and this is proof of this was a good success. Of course, here P3 is a young station that was part of that station, so that's why this is higher than this. But you can see 703,000 10 plus listeners are listening to the young stations, and they have an average age of 35, whereas the average age on all stations are 54.
И ова трети дел тоа се станици кои се наменети млади популации и кои се исто многу слушани, односно многу оди слушани некои што се биле. Просечно нив е три, просечно године слушаат за овие станици е 35, док е што за овие остали станици беше просечно старосна доб 54 години.
Okay, so the conclusion from the PPM, just looking at the PPM, you can see here that the TSL went up in average. This is 16, 17, 18, I don't know why that has left. Maybe I have to press one. There you go. And the day reach went from 67 to 57, and when you times listening minutes among listeners with the day reach percent, of course you come to the listening minutes among the population, and that went down from 85 minutes to 72 minutes. So a total of 15% drop in overall consumption on radio.
И се осебно, кој